All right, back at the Lake Wales Depot Museum. The reason why I decided to come back and film it again because it was closed for like a year. I heard they did a lot of changes since they reopened, so I thought I'd do a walkthrough again. When we come back out. Okay.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine. Hey, there's a little step there, so be careful. I'm not going to show a close-up of all the signs. But I know sometimes these videos are a little too long, so a little more.
I'm here until 5, so even if there's like some random day after school, you're like, I could just go over there and do a couple hours. Feel free, I'm here, so yeah.
And I try to make these walkthroughs not too long. So I won't be focusing on all these signs as much as I used to. But this place definitely looks different from what I remember. If you come here, you definitely gotta read all these in depth. Tower Gardens, St. Anne Shrine, both places I filmed on my channel if you're interested in seeing them. I will be going back to Bach Tower eventually and St. Anne Shrine to do some more filming. This famous tower, Bach Tower, I've actually been right in there. This place I filmed also, from the outside. I didn't film from in the inside. Particular display you want me to show better, let me know. I can always come back and film a closer look of those particular ones. But like I said, I'm mainly just doing an overview now, so the videos aren't that long. Didn't you used to be able to go in there?
Yeah, right now we have collections items in there that we're trying to catalog, so we are going to be opening it up hopefully next spring, but right now it's just full of collection objects, so it's locked for now.
Does that go for the train outside too?
The caboose outside is being restored currently, and the people who are restoring it hope to have it open probably in November.
Yeah, because I know the last time I was here a couple years ago, they were letting you in there.
In the caboose?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's since gone into disrepair, so to make it actually safe for people to go in, we needed to repair it. So hopefully the next time you come back, it will be available to go into.
Yeah, I will say, a lot of work, but it came together really nice.
unfortunately, can't get in there right now, which I did show in my previous video I filmed here, but it's going to look different. And I can't get in the caboose now because that's being renovated. But I'll definitely come back and refilm it. Petrified wood, some arrowheads, some banner stones, piece of a canoe from circa 500-600 CE. Cool fossils and stuff, and a spear point. Not fossils, that's pottery fragments, I think. Like I was saying, if any of you want some particular information, thing like that, you want me to do a closer look, let me know. And I will make sure when I come back, I'll film it. Okay. Well, that goes into a probably storeroom, of course, the bathrooms. This is immense. Look at that old sink. You don't see that anymore. Alright, I'm probably done filming inside. I'm going to go outside now. See you in a second. I'm just not showing you the outside of the building. I'll go down there in a minute. There's the train tracks, and you can tell these are definitely original. That old fence. Imagine back in the day when this was still in use. A lot of history here. I'm not sure you'd consider this pink or like salmon color. The museum in Winter Haven, which is at the Winter Haven Swimming Club, is a pink building too. They give them memorial bricks. You gotta be careful walking here with snakes. Get bitten by the wrong snake, you're in a world of hurt. Now, I was in there, the caboose, a couple years ago. So if you want to see what it looks like, check it out. But that's also being remodeled. Hopefully I'm allowed back here. I didn't see a sign saying no. Now this section here I was never in. Hopefully eventually. It's all fixed up, I'll be able to get in here too. But not now. This is pretty much it. I'm not going to go any farther because with my luck I will trip. But I'm going to be filming this on the other side when I get out there. You see a better look at it. Alright, pretty dark, you probably can't see much. I won't be able to see what you see until I get home. Anyways, let's head to start heading back so I can show the other angle of the train. Battery's getting low, so I better get going because I still have a lot more to show you. It's my fault, I gotta get a new battery for this camera. I know it's flashing red. So I'm gonna be coming again here anyway, so. But there's a cannon over there, that way. Another little building that's part of the property. And then there's one of those Blue Star Memorial Highway signs, which I'll probably take a picture of. I'll be able to film. There you go, and this camera flashing. It's my fault, I gotta get another battery. Actually, I want to get another camera. One that hopefully will be waterproof and has night vision. There's some underwater stuff and some things I want to film at night that this camera will not do very well. I'll show you the train now. If my camera dies before I get to the show you the cannon and that other little building down there, I'll just take some pictures and I'll add it to this. This I definitely want to show. Alright, here's the train which I showed you on the other side, which that's where I was. Look at the engine. I gotta say, you know, I know this train's not gonna move. I always found trains to be a little creepy when you're right in front of them like this, like they're gonna come alive. There's a movie with Leslie Nielsen, especially like a parody of the movie The Future that Harrison Ford did. Well, in that movie, train came alive and chased him off the track and everything. It actually creeped me out. We gotta keep an eye out. This track is not active, but that one is. I do not want to be near it when a train goes by, like I said. Find it a little bit creepy. I don't know why. You know, I find trains to be actually very interesting. That's where I was down there. There you go for that train. I'm definitely going to come back when I can go in there. Caboose, then you have the dining car and the engine. I don't know if they'll ever let you in the dining car, but I'm assuming that's going to be eventually remodeled too. Get you. Yeah. But this museum is located in Lake Wales and South Scenic Road or Boulevard. If you check online, you can find the address. I think it's like 325, something like that. But be sure, make sure you check online. Alrighty, let's put you back forward again. Make it over there so I can show you at least the little house over there is part of the property too. And like the lady I talked to in there, she mentioned that it used to be a children's museum, which I did read online too. Actually, and I don't think I saw it, but back where the train was, I think there's another building past that, I think she said, it's part of the property too. Oh, here it goes. Cannon from the USS Constitution. Got a little pathway here to walk. Some tables. Like the John Pitt Tomlinson Memorial Garden. Let me show you one of these Blue Star Memorial Highway signs. And I know where there's a location for a couple others. So I'm definitely going to track them down and film them, and then I'll note the location. Here's the building that used to be the Children's Museum. I think she said there's like one other building in the opposite area, I think. Unless she was talking about that building over there. Not sure, but that's could be. I'll go over there and I'll see. It has to be part of it. So I'm going to fill it. Battery ran out, but I was able to turn it back on. So I'm gonna